Watertown, Wisconsin. This game will feature the Commonwealth Christian School of Richmond, Virginia. And they are one of the tournament favorites here. You should have seen their warm-ups. They were intimidating as they could possibly be, and obviously they tried to do that. About five out of the top 10 players on their team can stuff the basketball. Their heights are incredible. 6'5", 6'5", 6'5", 6'2", 6'2". It just keeps going on, 6'4". And they will face the New Testament Christian School of Norton, Massachusetts. And it looks as though it just might be a little bit one-sided. Here tonight with Commonwealth, as we mentioned, one of the favored teams in this tournament. First of all, for Commonwealth. Here's number five, Ray Currents. Here's number four, Brian Edmonds. Number 11 is Shane Truly. Here's Larry Turner, number 21. Rounding out the starting lineup, here's Ricky Smith wearing number 22. And now for the New Testament Christian School from Norton, Massachusetts. Number 20. This is Ron Farron, the starter, number 35. Number 5 is Kerry Garvin. This is Schatzberger. And number 12 is Phil Clater. Missed a couple there as they had their jerseys on, trying to get the numbers on the front, and it's just a little bit impossible. Number 25 is Joe Hayes. He'll be starting also. And now as we look up and look down and try to pick up the final number, looks like number 30, Tim Clater. So we got Phil Clater and Tim both starting. Schatzberger, Hayes, and Farron. For Commonwealth again, Turley, Currents, Turner, Edmonds, and Smith. Ready to go. The baskets have been pointed out. The final instructions have been given. Basketball is in the air, and the tip is controlled by Commonwealth. This is number 21, Larry Turner. Turner kicks it back outside to Shane Turley. Turley over on the left side to Currents. Turley with a shot, no good, off the front of the rim. Currents follows, he hits it. Ray Currents puts Commonwealth on the board, 2-0. Full court press immediately being applied by Commonwealth. I'm sure that they'd like to get the big lead quick and keep it. They are an intimidating looking basketball team, and you've just got to admire the height and the speed that these young men have. Now the ball is lost out of bounds by New Testament Christian School, and Commonwealth has an opportunity to go up in front 4-0. Number 11 again, Shane Turley. This is Currents. His next shot off the backboard, no good. Followed and put down by number 4, Brian Edmonds, and it's 4-0 Commonwealth. Again, the full court press ties up the team from Norton, Massachusetts. They lose the ball out of bounds, but it was tipped away by Commonwealth. So again, as we mentioned before, let's just start referring to them as Virginia and Massachusetts for sake of brevity. Massachusetts now with the basketball. Long cross-court pass across the 10-second line. This is Ron Farron. Farron gets the basketball over to Joe Hayes. Stolen by Commonwealth. Here they come on the breakaway. Checked away by the behind-the-back pass. Clater goes down for Massachusetts. He got fouled. Foul is going to go against number 4, I believe, and indeed that's what it is. And that would be Brian Edmonds, so he's whistled for a foul. We've got a quick timeout called by Massachusetts, so we'll take a break here and be back in just 1 minute with the balance of first quarter action. Commonwealth with the basketball from Virginia. As we begin play again in the first quarter after the timeout. Inbound pass stolen by Massachusetts. Number 35, Ron Farron, stolen right back by Virginia. Basket is good by Larry Turner, and it's an 8-0 Virginia lead. Here comes Massachusetts, number 30 on the pass, trying to get it inside is Tim Clater. And I believe it was tipped away by Commonwealth. Indeed it was. So the basketball will still belong to Massachusetts. Joe Hayes on the inbound pass. Hayes inbounding to Clater, Tim Clater. Tim's shot, good. And Massachusetts is finally on the board. 8-2 the score. Virginia leads it. 6 minutes remaining in the first quarter. We're just underway here at Watertown, Wisconsin at Maranatha College. The National Tournament of Christian Schools. This is it. Game number 4 on the first day. Massachusetts now with the basketball. This is Clater. Gets it over to Farron. Down inside underneath to Schatzberger. His shot up, but he gets called on the travel before he got the shot away. And again, Virginia's basketball. Two guards for Virginia. Currents and Turley. Currents will take the shot. In and out, no good. And as the rebound comes down to Larry Turner, he tries to go back up with it. Looked as though the ball was partially checked. Turner came down with it again after the jump. Gets called on a travel. Massachusetts basketball. Farron down to the baseline. Off the glass. Shot put up there by Phil Clater, and it's 8-4. As Massachusetts begins to bring it back. They have cut the 8-0 lead in half now. Inside, shot taken from the baseline and missed. 3 second violation goes against Virginia, and it's again Massachusetts basketball. Shot was taken by Brian Edmonds. Again, the full court press being applied by Virginia. And as Joe Hayes tries to pass down to the baseline, he throws it out of bounds, and it's Virginia basketball. Now 5 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Here comes Virginia again. This is Turley to Currents. Back outside to the big guy, number 22, Ricky Smith, who has just come into the ball game. His shot no good, and Massachusetts comes away with the basketball. Stolen by Ricky Smith. Here he comes on the fast break. Let's watch him stuff it. Boom! Ricky Smith. That turns the crowd on. 10-4, Virginia. Drive to the bucket by Farron. His shot won't go. Contact under the basket, but no foul. Now the alley-oop. And they tried to get it in to Larry Turner for the alley-oop jam. He couldn't get the basketball. Shot up by Edmonds, no good. And now we've got a whistle. And a violation goes against Massachusetts. It's Virginia basketball under the basket. Edmonds shot off the front of the rim. Rebound comes away to Clayton. That's Phil Clater, rather. Phil and Tim both in the basketball game. Tim on the shot off the back of the rim. Rebound to Brian Edmonds of Virginia. Turley has his shot checked away by Tim Clater, but I think they got Clater on the foul as he caught Turley on the arm on the check. Indeed, they did. So Clater picks up a foul. With 3 minutes and 42 seconds remaining in the first quarter, Virginia 10. And Massachusetts has 4 points. Norton, Massachusetts, to be exact. Richmond, Virginia. At the foul line, Shane Turley. Waiting now for some type of a problem at the official scorer's table. We can't see down there. Our broadcast table is so high. It really gets in our way and blocks our view of the official scoring table. But we seem to have had it, cleared up. We're ready to go. This is Turley at the foul line. Turley gets his first point of the night, and it's an 11-10 or 11-4 Virginia lead. Make that 12. This is Clater with a basketball from Massachusetts. Stolen cleanly by Currents. He flips it over to Edmonds, and he gets his sixth point of the night. Drive all the way to the bucket. Pinned against the backboard by big Ricky Smith. Here comes Massachusetts on the steal again as Smith couldn't get the pass down court. Oh, my. Smith listed as 6'5". He is only a junior, but he'll be back next year. There's Smith on the drive, tries to stuff it, can't get it, but Turley follows and puts it back in. 16-4, and as we had anticipated earlier, this is going to be a little bit of a mismatch, unfortunately. Stolen again by Commonwealth, and we get a violation, a 3-second violation, I believe. Let's see what the call is. No, we're going to get a foul. No basket. Foul was on number 25 of Massachusetts. That would be Joe Hayes. Well, he picks up his first personal. Well, this team from Richmond, Virginia, looks like they are going to be very, very tough to beat. They are in the opposite bracket from Anchorage Christian School. So they probably will meet in the championship game if KCS can win their basketball game tomorrow. Stolen away again, but stolen back by Massachusetts. And here's Clater on a drive. Big check by Ricky Smith again. Long pass down court. Here comes the jam again. Boom! Number 21. Larry Turner with his fourth point of the night. Oh, my. Well, you just can't help but sit there and in awe when you see these young men with a two-handed stuff, not even one. And they can really get up. Ricky Smith again with a check off the backboard. Alley-oop pass. Turner can't get it to go down. He's tried that a couple of times tonight. So Turley breaks in from the right side. Turner comes roaring in from the left, and he alley-oops it up there. Turner's missed both times. Well, actually, Turley missed with his pass the first time. Turner couldn't get the stuff the second. Good job of acting by Larry Turner as he goes down. He was hardly touched at all by the young man from Massachusetts. But we do get a turnover, no foul, as the turnover was in the front court. Across the center line now is Shane Turley. He goes down the right-hand side. Currents will take the shot and hit it. Ray Currents, he's got 4 points. And it's a 20-4 Virginia lead. Stolen again inside. This time Turley puts the shot down, but we got a traveling violation against Ray Currents. Virginia just does not even let Massachusetts get the ball across the center line about half of the time before they tip it away or make the steal. Yeah, this full court press that they apply, they smother it. Tipped away again and out of bounds as Clater tried to pass up to the center court line, couldn't even get past the free throw line that time. Inbound pass comes in now from Joe Hayes. This is Ron Ferrand. Underneath, wide open. Pass hits Phil Clater right in the face. He loses one of the lenses out of his glasses. And finally, on the other end of the court, Larry Turner puts the shot down. Clater got hit right in the eye with that pass as it went through his hands, knocked the lens out of the left lens out of his glasses. It went flying across the floor. And they finally get a whistle and an official timeout to pick up the lens. Clater is going to stay in there. He'll just work without his glasses. And now one of the crowd favorites. The big guy, and he can rival Mojo out there. This is John Delahanty. Excuse me, this is Sylvester Clay. Sylvester Clay wearing number 24. Oh, look at that check off the board. Well, Sylvester gets on the board right away, but what a block by Turner. And now Massachusetts again throws the basketball away, and it'll be Virginia basketball. And this is just a clinic for these young men from Massachusetts. 24-4, we are still in the first quarter. 44 seconds remain. This is Clay with the basketball. He'll take the shot. He's not afraid to put it up. Massachusetts saves, comes away to Ricky Smith. Smith, pass to Turner. His shot, good. Basket will count. 26-4, and he got the foul. It's going to be number 12, and that's Phil Clater. He's the man that lost his glasses. Well, at the foul line now with 34 seconds remaining, Larry Turner. Commonwealth has been to the foul line twice. Shane Turley is 2-for-2. They've actually been there once. He made them both. Turner shot good. He's got 9 on the evening. 27-24. Inbound to Tim Clater. To Ferrin. Back over to Joe Hayes. Stolen again by Commonwealth. Here they come on the fast break. Another stuff? No, as Massachusetts number 10, I'm searching for the number, that's Schatzberger, reaches in and knocks the ball away from Ricky Smith. So Smith doesn't get an opportunity to jam, but he'll be at the free throw line with a two-shot foul. As Schatzberger picks up the foul. Ricky Smith, so far tonight, just 2 points as he misses the first of two free throws. And now give him 3 as he converts. 28-4. See if Massachusetts can slow it down and take a final shot. Pass inside, gets away from Phil Clater. So it looks like Virginia will have the final shot of the first quarter. See if they can run it up to 30-4 before this quarter ends. With the basketball now, Shane Turley. Down to 7, now 6. Turley will take the shot off the front of the rim. No good. Put back up and missed. And the buzzer goes before we can get another shot away in the first quarter. And that's the way it ends after 8 minutes of play. Virginia 28 and Massachusetts 4. Well, we could see that it was going to be a little bit one-sided, but we didn't think it would be quite this one-sided. Virginia Commonwealth has now scored 20 unanswered points against Massachusetts. It was 8-4. It is now 28-4. As the young men from Richmond, Virginia, as we mentioned, have scored 20 consecutive points without being answered by a basket from Massachusetts. Massachusetts with the ball to begin the quarter will have the opportunity to do that. Checked away by Ricky Smith. He saves. Here comes another possible stuff. This is Turley. He's not quite that big. He'll just lay it in. Shane Turley with his 6th point of the evening, and it's 30-4. Now 22 unanswered points scored by Virginia without a basket from Massachusetts. Down to the baseline. Shot taken. Down goes the big guy. A couple of Virginia players on top of him. Turley to Turner. His shot good. Larry Turner. And he's got 11, and it's 32-4. And now they have scored a total of 24 unanswered points. Into the baseline, shot put up by Massachusetts. Clater, very short. Here comes Turner on the drive. Ricky Smith, boom, another jam for Ricky. We'll keep track of the stuff so far here tonight. That's 4 so far in the basketball game. Smith's got 2. We'll just make some little asterisks out here. Turner's got 1. Check that. Turner's got 2. And Smith's got 2. Well, we love the big guy, number 24. Lester Clay. Drive by Massachusetts hits the side of the backboard. Here comes Turner, followed by Ricky Smith, no good. Smith back up again, no good. Turley with a rebound. His shot again off the side of the rim. Smith finally puts it down, and I think he got fouled. If he did, the basket's going to count. Let's see what the call is. Fouls on number 35. Basket counts. 35 is Ron Ferrand. Smith just continued to battle inside. Used that superior height advantage he has at 6'5". Smith's free throw, good. He's 2 for 3 from the line. Again, as we said, just take a look at the lineup. The heights are amazing. 6'5", 6'even, 6'2", 6'4", 6'5", 6'5", and 6'2". Just some of the six-footers in there for Virginia Commonwealth. Shot taken by Clater, Tim Clater, no good. Shot from the corner by Shane Turley goes from the baseline. Would have been a three-pointer if they were counting it. I've been calling the team Virginia Commonwealth. I apologize for that. I believe that's a college down there. It's not really Virginia Commonwealth. It's Commonwealth Christian School in Richmond, Virginia. Turnaround jumper, and look at this. Phil Clater finally puts Massachusetts on the board. And now we get a basket and a foul at the other end. Foul is going to go against number 25. Basket is good. Bucket was by Shane Turley. And the foul was committed by Joe Hayes. Now out of the ball game comes Turner, and back in for Virginia, Ray Currents. Turley will be at the line. 41-6 the score. Turley's shot good. 42-6. 5 minutes and 15 seconds still remain in the half. A couple of teams so far today didn't score 42 points in the entire ballgame. And Virginia is just singeing the nets. Now a pass from Massachusetts again goes astray. And here comes Virginia with a basketball. This is Turley. Over to Currents. Tries to get it inside to the big guy, Clay. Traveling call. Well, as we mentioned, Clay will rival John Muldrow from Anchorage in size. In fact, he may even be a little bit bigger. And wouldn't it be interesting to see those two go at it under the basket? Clay looks like he weighs pretty close to about 300 even. Here comes Ricky Smith on the steal. Turner tries to jam it, can't do it, and the rebound comes off to Ron Ferrand. Well, it wasn't a really well-advised jam as he had a couple of players around him. Now Clay goes for the steal, and I'm sure they're going to get him on the foul as he made hard contact with Joe Hayes. Clay is smiling like he just can't believe that it happened. Now he gives the referee a handshake. Massachusetts will inbound the basketball. This is Tim Clater. Now we've got a whistle and another foul. And this time it's going to go against Turley. So Shane Turley picks up his first personal. Massachusetts will inbound. This is Joe Hayes. To Clater. Turnaround jumper in and out by Farron. The rebound taken away by Massachusetts. But here comes Turner with a basketball. Excuse me. Yeah, Turner with the basketball. Now we've got another foul. Now some substitutions for Virginia. Number 25 and number 3. 23, rather. And that's John Delahanty and Adam Dean, respectively. Delahanty wearing number 25. Dean wearing number 23. Now a substitution for Massachusetts. Number 13, Mike Tremblay, replaces Schatzberger. At the foul line, Larry Turner. One situation, Turner will be awarded another. Turner's next foul shot gives him 13 points on the night, and it's 44-6. Yes, that is the real score. You are not having problems with your TV set. Rebound comes away again to Larry Turner. Here comes Virginia. Turner trying to drive the key, gets it knocked away, flips it right into the hands of Tim Clater. Here comes Clater of Massachusetts. Jump shot from the top of the key, bounces, rolls, and goes. As Tim Clater's got four. Brother Phil Clater, I believe it's his brother, has four. And so far it's Virginia 44 and the Claters 8. Now finally Ricky Smith misses as he tries to get the pass into number 23, Adam Dean. And it's Massachusetts basketball, and that's one of the few real legitimate turnovers that Virginia has committed so far here tonight. Pass inside to number 13 for Mass. Well, that's about the way it goes. Tremblay wide open with nobody on him, and he can't hit the little layup. Basket by Adam Dean gives him his first two of the night. Well, when it rains, it pours, I guess. Massachusetts just can't get it together so far. Long shot taken from downtown by Joe Hayes, and he gets his first 2 points of the night, and it's 46-10. Shot put up by Smith, no good, and we've got a battle for the basketball under the basket. It's going to be awarded to Illinois. Adam Dean on the inbound pass now. Gets it back outside to John Delahanty. Inside to the big guy, Clay. Stolen by Massachusetts. Here they come with the basketball. Ricky Smith all over Tim Clater. Clater takes it to the bucket, misses the shot, but I think Smith got him on the foul. And it is indeed not Smith. It is number 25 that picks up the foul. And that would be John Delahanty. And now, Coach Alvin Tellant. 46-10. Virginia leads it. Waiting now for a clarification from the official scorer, one of the officials talking with them. That's the delay. As we continue to wait. Again, we are coming to you from Watertown, Wisconsin, from Maranatha College in Watertown. This is the 9th Annual American Association of Christian Schools National Basketball Tournament. The National Championship, Game 4 of the first day. Tomorrow we'll be coming back at you again here from Watertown at 1:15, 3 o'clock, and then again at 6 and 7:45. And Saturday, three games will be played here at 9, 10:45, and the championship at 1. The two teams that lose their first two games will automatically be eliminated from the tournament. They will not play on Saturday. So there will be 11 games in all. Now another substitution for Virginia is number 10, Al Burton. Number 20 also in there for Virginia, Greg Martin. All right, Massachusetts will inbound right in front of our camera position. Inbound pass comes to Tim Clater. Clater over on the right wing to Ron Ferrin. Stolen by Adam Dean. Here comes Virginia with 2.5 minutes remaining in the ballgame. Long pass inside, try to hit Al Burton. Couldn't quite get him as it was a little bit high for Burton to reach. And again, it's Massachusetts basketball. Tim Clater. Virginia in a man-to-man defense again. Stolen inside. Here comes Dean. Here's the big guy with the basketball. Let's see what he does with it. Behind the back pass. Traveling violation's got to be called, as Al Burton took about 4 or 5 steps with a basketball, or at least 4. And it's, again, it's a turnover to Massachusetts. And now you can see the vast difference between the starting five and the bench for Virginia. This is actually a pretty good ball game right now without the starting five in there for Virginia. Joe Hayes shot in and out, rolls around, comes back out again. And if Virginia was to start... Number 20, by the way, picked up that foul. And for Virginia, that's Greg Martin. If Virginia was to start their bench, their second five, we'd have a pretty good ball game here tonight. out of the basketball game comes number 13. That's Mike Tremblay. And in the game, number 11, Eric Rose. We have not seen him so far tonight from Massachusetts. Phil Clater adds to his point total. He now has 5. As the Clater brothers have, if they are brothers, I am assuming they are, have all but 2 of the points for Massachusetts. And Clater now has 6, and he leads the team. Tim Clater has 4, and Joe Hayes has contributed 2. That's their 13. Burton all the way across to Clay. He'll take the shot way short off the front of the rim. Battles for the rebound. Can't get it. One of the young men from Massachusetts picks it up. It's Joe Hayes, but he gets called on a travel before he can get the ball back inside, and it's Virginia's ball into the bucket. Pass inside to Clay. Shot left-handed. Bad shot off the glass. Not a good shot selection at all by Clay. A little bit of showboating on his part. And the turnover goes to Massachusetts now on the out-of-bounds. Tim Clater over on the left-hand side to Joe Hayes. Jump shot taken and missed by Phil Clater. Here comes Virginia with a rebound. Taken on the boards by John Delahanty. Shot will be taken from the baseline by Adam Dean, followed in there by Al Burton. And now the ball is lost again out of bounds, a 3-second violation on Virginia. And Massachusetts picks up the basketball. Across the 10-second line again is Clater. His shot, no good. Rebound to Burton. Long pass down court. They had a wide-open breakaway for Dean. Now they finally get it to him, and he puts it off the glass and in. Adam Dean with 4 points on the evening, 48-13. Clater with a shot. He gets fouled. And I think number 20, Greg Martin, got him. Let's see how they call it. Indeed, it is Greg Martin, number 20. That's his second foul. And this is number 30 again, Tim Clater. Clater with 4 points on the night, trying to make it 5. Off the glass, an unusual foul shot, if indeed he was trying to do it that way. Let's see if he banks it off the glass this time. I think that was really a miss that just went in. Clater taking a lot of time at the line. This time he pops it straight through, and indeed he missed the first one, but he made it anyway off the glass. 48-15. The score, Virginia leading. Massachusetts has been able to put a couple of points on the board since Virginia brought in their second string from the bench. Now we get another 3-second violation called against Burton this time of Virginia, and Massachusetts will have the basketball with 23 seconds remaining. Now Ricky Smith back in the basketball game. He'll come in for Greg Martin. So Smith will finish out the first half. Seconds on the clock now as Massachusetts crosses the center line. Tipped away, stolen by Virginia. Burton runs into Delahanty from behind, but they managed to recover. Burton with the basketball now. 6 seconds. Clay will take the shot. He's not shy about that. And we get a whistle and a foul called on number 25. That is Joe Hayes. And for Hayes, that's his third. So to the foul line, Sylvester Clay. Clay will have an opportunity for another one. This time he still can't make good as he misses 2 from the line, followed by Dean, no good, put back up and missed by Burton at the buzzer. So we are through one half of play here at Watertown, Wisconsin in the American Association of Christian Schools National Championship Tournament. The score, Virginia 48, Massachusetts 15.